Welcome back to Pharmacology Classes by MSR. In this video, I will explain about blood collection techniques in laboratory animals. In previous videos, I have explained about species and strains of animals and other video of transgenic and mutant animals. So the next topic in Unit 1 is techniques of blood collection. Collection of blood sample plays a key role in our scientific research. So, when we are collecting the blood sample, the animal should not undergo any stress. If the animal is undergoing any stress, it will show the effect on our results of our scientific study. So, the results may be altered because of a stress of the animal. So, there are certain guidelines to be followed to collect the blood sample from the animals. So, just now I told that whenever we are collecting the blood sample, the animal should have less stress. If the stress is more, our results will be altered. So how the results are altered because of stress of the animal is, they may have increased blood levels of catecholamines or the prolactin levels, glucocorticoids may be altered, the erythrocytes level, WBC levels may be altered because of the excess stress. Apart from that, whenever we are collecting blood from the animals, we have to collect the amount of the blood depending upon the species, age, sex and health of that particular animal. So if you take the older animals, the blood volume in their body will be less when compared to the normal one. So there will be approximately 55 to 70 ml per kg of the body weight. So depending upon the body weight of animal, we have to take the blood sample. So what precautions you have to follow when we are collecting a blood sample? Whenever we are collecting the blood or drawing the blood from the animal, it should be less painful for the animal. When collecting a blood, we can collect by anesthetizing the animal or non-anesthetizing the animal. Apart from that, we have to have proper training. Without the proper training, we should not collect blood from the animal because it may be causing pain, stress for the animals. So always we have to minimize the pain and distress for the animal. So a well-trained professional is required for drawing the blood sample from the animals, and we have to collect the blood sample only if it is required for good scientific reason, for humanitarian reasons, when it is useful for the human society, only we have to collect the blood samples from the animals. The general principles include the blood sample collection method. Whatever procedure you are following to collect the blood, that particular procedure should be mentioned in the protocol of IAEC, Institutional Animal Ethical Committee. Then, how many times you are taking the blood sample? Usually, once in 2 weeks is ideal for non-rodents. But if you are collecting excess times, more than once or twice, multiple blood collection is done from the same animal, we can use a temporary cannula so that it will minimize the pain and stress for the animals. Then, only 10% of circulating blood volume is preferable to be taken from the animals. If you are taking more than 10% of the total blood volume, we have to give the fluid replacement for the animals. We can give the lactator Ringer solution, that is recommended fluid replacement by the NIH. Apart from that, if the blood collection is exceeding more than 30%, we have to take care of the animal so that it will not suffer from hypovolemia, decreased blood volume. So continuous fluid replacement should be done so that the animal will recover. So what are the methods for blood collection? So blood collection can be done by giving anesthesia or without requiring the anesthesia. So blood collection not requiring anesthesia includes saphenous vein method, dorsal pedal vein method, whereas the blood collection that requires the anesthesia includes the tail vein, tail snip, retroorbital sinus, jugular vein, temporary cannula, blood vessel cannulation, tarsal vein, marginal vein, all this require the anesthesia to collect the blood sample. Then the next method is terminal procedure, the N method. We are going to take the blood sample from the animal, which may terminate the life of the animal. That includes the cardiac puncture and orbital sinus and posterior vena cava. These are the three methods which includes in the terminal procedure. When collecting the blood sample with anesthesia, the anesthesia we provide may be for a shorter duration, medium or longer anesthesia. So depending upon the animal we are going to collect the blood, the anesthetic drug may be varied. Some of them includes isoflurane, ketamine, xylazine, etc. The first method for the blood sample collection without anesthesia includes the saphenous vein method. So in this method, as the name indicates, we are going to take the blood sample from the saphenous vein, which is present at the back of the hind limb. So we can shave that particular region so that the vein is exposed, from where we can collect the blood. So we can use rodent handling gloves, towel, cotton, and for sample collection we require a needle, 20 gauze needle. So we will shave or we will apply the hair removal cream so that we can have the exposure for saphenous vein. We can hold the animal directly or you can use the restrainer. Once the saphenous vein is exposed, by using this 20 gauze needle, we are going to puncture the saphenous vein and collect the blood sample by using the syringe or by the capillary tube. So during this blood collection sampling method, we have to use a local anesthetic so that it will minimize the pain for the animal. Not more than 3 attempts should be made to collect the blood sample, and continuous blood sample should be prevented, and more than 4 blood samplings is not preferable for the saphenous vein method. The next method without anesthesia includes the dorsal pedal vein method. So in this method also we require the gloves, cotton, capillary tubes, and the gauze size will be 23 or 27 needle to collect the blood sample. So we can keep the animal in the restrainer. We can take the hind foot around the ankle and we can see the medial dorsal pedal vessel that is located on the top of the foot is located. We can clean the foot with absolute alcohol and the pedal vein should be exposed. Once it is exposed, we can puncture it with the gauze needle of 23 or 27. Once we puncture this particular pedal vein, we will have the appearance of blood. We can collect it by using a syringe or by using a capillary tube. Once the blood sampling is done, we should apply the pressure so that we can stop the bleeding. The blood collection methods which require anesthesia under the first method is tail vein method. So commonly used equipment when we collect the blood sample includes a syringe, towel, cotton, rodent handling gloves, capillary tubes, restrainer. All this will be commonly used for the blood collection methods. So when we are taking the blood from this tail vein method, the larger volumes of blood can be collected. We can use a restrainer so that we can make the animal comfortable. Excess of rubbing of the tail should be prevented because it may cause leukocytosis. Excess rubbing means what happens? Then WBC will be accumulated in that particular region. We can apply a local anesthetic cream so that it will prevent or minimize the pain for the animal. We can use a 23 gauze needle which can be inserted into the blood vessel and we can take the blood sample from the animal. Once the blood sampling is done, we can apply pressure to prevent the blood flow, or we can apply the silver nitrate ointment or solution to stop the bleeding. The next method is blood sample collection with a temporary cannula. So when you want to collect the blood samples in a periodic time interval, so multiple punctures can be prevented when you use a temporary cannula. So when we are cannulating, from the same cannula we can take multiple blood samples in periodic intervals. So for this we require a warming chamber. So because of the warming chamber, what happens is the blood vessels are dilated so that we can easily cannulate the tail vein. Then we require a 25 gauze needle. Before doing this cannulation process, we have to do anesthesia, apply local anesthetic to the tail vein. And once the cannulation is done, we have to keep the animal separately in large cages. So what is the protocol we need to follow when we are doing this cannulation process? So whenever we are cannulating, we have to use the anesthetizing agent to prevent excess pain for the animals. And we have to use 25 gauze needle.
We have to use a surgical blade, heparin, which acts as an anticoagulant, and we have to monitor the animal because we are taking the continuous blood samples. And this cannulation can be done for the femoral artery or femoral vein, carotid artery, jugular vein, vena cava or dorsal artery, we can cannulate. So anesthesia is mandatory when you are cannulating, and when you are taking the blood sample, it should be replaced with the liquids, LRS, lactate ringer solution or anything, it should be replaced. And we have to prevent the infection for the animal as it is cannulated. So we have to wash it with the anticoagulant agent to prevent the clotting, blocking of the cannula. All this should be prevented, and utmost care should be taken when we are cannulating the animal. So different animals, we are using different sizes of needle, and the volume of blood collected may vary depending upon the size of the animal. So if you consider the smallest animal, mice, we can use 22-3 to 25 gauze needle, and the maximum blood volume collection can be 1 ml. Whereas for rat, 19 to 21 gauze and blood volume is 10 to 15 ml. Rabbit, 19 to 21 gauze needle can be used, and we can collect the blood up to 60 to 200 ml, that is maximum. Guinea pig, 20 to 21 gauze and the blood volume is 1 to 25 ml. So depending upon the weight of the animal, we have to use the needle size and also the volume of blood collection depends on the weight of the animal. Tail snip blood collection method. So this method is preferred only for mice. We have to apply anesthetic agent. We can use a needle. We can use a surgical blade. So as the name indicates, tail snip blood collection method, the tail tip of the mice is cut with a scalpel blade up to 1 mm and the blood is being collected. Once you collect the required amount of the blood sample, the blood flow is stopped by dapping the tail tip. So the next method is orbital sinus blood sample collection. So don't be worried by seeing the slide. I want to give all the information in the slide so that you can prepare for your exams also. So whenever we are using this method, we have to anesthetize the animal by using a general anesthesia, and we should apply topical anesthetic for the ophthalmic region before the eye is bleeding. So the animal is scruffled with the thumb, nothing but it is folded with the thumb and the forefinger, and the skin around the eye should be pulled out. Then the capillary tube, whatever is there, that should be inserted into the eye in 30 degrees angle to the nose. So when we are inserting this capillary tube into the eye region, the blood will start flowing into the capillary tube. So this procedure should be done after proper training with supervision, and we should not take repeated blood samples as we are taking through the orbital of the eye animal. Proper training and skills are required to collect blood sample by this method. And this method, if it is not done properly, it may lead infection to the animal. The animal may develop hematoma, corneal ulcerations, keratitis, pannus formation, rupture of the eye orbit. So damage to the eye nerves, this all can be happened if the person is not trained properly. So only a well-trained person with proper skills should use this method for collecting the blood sample. Next method is jugular vein method. So in this method, for all the methods commonly we use an anesthetizing agent, 25 gauze needle depending upon the animal size, collecting tube, blood sample collecting tubes. These are all commonly used when we are doing the blood sample collection. So in this method, we can use either a general anesthetic or an inhalation anesthetic. So as the name indicates, it is a jugular vein blood sample. Where is this jugular vein present? If you take the neck region of the animal, we can find this jugular vein. So what we have to do is, we have to properly shave and clean the neck region of the animal, and we have to hyperextend, nothing but pull back the head of the animal, hyperextended position. So when you do this hyperextension of the animal, you can see a jugular vein which is blue in color, okay, in the sternoclavicular region, nothing but to the sternum and clavicle bone. So there you can find a vein, jugular vein, which is bluish in color. So we can use 25 gauze needle. We have to insert it into the jugular vein in the direction of caudocephalic, nothing but we have to move it back to front. and you should not penetrate very deep. You should just penetrate it maximum of 3 to 4 mm. Then we have to take the blood sample. If you find that if you are not inserted it properly, you can take it back and check whether any bleeding is happening. If no bleeding is recognized, then we can do this procedure once again. So maximum attempt should be limited to 3. You should not do it again and again. And once this procedure is done, you have to apply a local anesthetic in the region where you have used this needle, so that you have penetrated the needle into the animal. You can apply a local anesthetic so that animal pain can be minimized. Next method is tarsal vein method. So, as for all the methods, this method also needs a gauze needle which is 22 size, and we require a hair remover cream and blood collection tubes. So in the hind legs of the animal, we can find this tarsal vein. So what we have to do is, we have to take the hind limb of the animal, we have to do the hair remover for that particular limb so that the tarsal vein can be appeared in bluish in color. We have to apply a local anesthetic cream. Once we apply the cream, after 30 minutes we can use the needle, we can penetrate into the tarsal vein and we can take the blood sample. So from each leg we can take 0.3 to 0.3 ml of the blood per sample, and maximum samples should be taken only 2 or 3 times. Attempt should not be more than 3. So hair removal, apply of local anesthetic is mandatory when we are collecting the blood sample by this tarsal vein method. The next method is marginal ear vein method or marginal ear artery method. As the name indicates, from the ear vein or ear artery, we are going to take the blood sample. This is most preferred method in the rabbits. So we can use a gauze size of 26 gauze size needle. And the ear vein or the ear artery is either cut or the needle is being penetrated into the ear artery or vein and the blood sample is collected. So before this procedure, we can use xylene or any other vasodilator to dilate these arteries or veins so that we can easily take the blood sample. The animal should be placed in a restrainer and the blood sample should be collected. Once the blood sample is collected, we have to gently press the area where we have penetrated so that we can prevent the flow of blood. The cardiac puncture, which is a terminal blood collection method. So cardiac puncture, we are puncturing the cardiac region, nothing but the heart, to take the blood sample. So this procedure is done by the requirement of anesthesia. The gauze size of the needle should be 19 to 25. We require a surgical blade and we require a tube with a diameter of 0.1 to 0.3 mm for thoracotomy. Thoracotomy is nothing but it is a surgical procedure where we will make a cut in between the ribs so that we can get the exposure to the lungs or the heart or any other internal organ. So from that we can take the blood sample. So the cardiac puncture will be recommended only in the terminal stage. I just now told it is a terminal procedure. In the end state only we will do this particular procedure. When we require high amount of the blood, large volumes of blood, and that is required for our study, then only this procedure is required. Okay. So we will give the anesthesia to the animal, terminal anesthesia. We will make a puncture to the heart. Usually we will take the blood samples from the ventricles. So slowly we will take the blood from the ventricles so that the collapsing of the heart can be prevented. So cardiac puncture, it is a terminal method. We will give the anesthesia. Large volume of blood is required, and if your procedure really requires the quality of this particular blood sample, then only this procedure is required as it is a terminal method. We are going to make a thoracotomy. We will make a cut in between the ribs so that the lungs or heart can be exposed. So and then they are punctured and we are taking the blood sample. Blood sample from the posterior vena cava, which is a terminal blood sample collection method. So like all the methods here also, we require the anesthetic agent, surgical blade, scissors, gauze needles, syringe and collecting tubes to collect the blood. So it is required during the terminal stage of the study. Where we can find this posterior vena cava is in between the kidneys. We can see this posterior vena cava. So to identify that the animal is anesthetized, Y or V shaped cut is made in the abdomen, and usually the intestines are removed and The liver is pushed forward so that the posterior vena cava is exposed. Once this is exposed, by using a syringe or a needle, we will insert it into the posterior vena cava and we will take the blood sample. So this procedure is repeated 3 or 4 times to collect more volume of the blood.